is going on? Praise God. First of all, I'd like to tell everybody, Happy New Year. To God be the glory. We made it out of 2020, and now we are embarked on a whole new year, 2021. Can you see it? Okay, so we didn't expect 2020 to go the way that it did. At least I didn't. I don't know about you. And but it did. It went the way that it did. Praise God. But look, that's behind us now. We're in 2021. We got a whole new year ahead of us. A lot of people are looking at this as a kind of reset. And so here's a chance to start over. First of all, I'd like to tell you all, Happy New Year. Praise God. Listen, I think that for this year, we just need to continue doing what we've been doing, in the sense that the emphasis needs to be kingdom. I think that the church needs to be focused on being the church. And the only way that the church can really focus on being the church is by knowing what the church is supposed to do. And the only way the church can really know what they're supposed to do is by getting into the Word of God. My stance is exactly the same. We need scripture as a foundation. And having said that, I want to invite you all to Bible in a year. Yes, we're going to read through the Bible. All right, look, check this out. I'm not going to be doing brand new videos. And here's why. Because I've looked at the new reading plan, Bible in a Year 2021, and they're using the exact same scriptures for every single day. And I've already done a video for every single day. But I will be participating in the reading plan and refreshing myself with Bible in a Year 2021. And as I feel led to, or as I feel the need to update or add something new, I'll do that on occasion here and there. So all the videos for the video series, Bible in a Year, are already on the YouTube channel. I just want to encourage you to develop a habit of getting into the Word of God every single day for yourself. Do it for yourself. Do it to develop the discipline. Do it to develop a habit. If you have not already done so, get into the Bible every single day. Why? Because the Bible is the Word of God. It's the Word of truth. In this age of deception, we need the truth of God's word more than we need anything, because it is the spiritual air that we breathe, the word of God. And we've got to know what the word says. We have to know what the Bible says. The Bible teaches us how to live. The Bible teaches us how to be children of God. The Bible teaches us who God is. Now, I thank God for teachers. I thank God for preachers. And these people are good. They're part of the fivefold ministry. But that doesn't take away from getting into your own studies. That doesn't take away from getting into your own personal time with God. We need to be intentional. We need to be intentional about spending time with God. We need to be intentional about reading the Bible. We need to be intentional about praying and about worshiping. Let's not offer Jesus cheap worship this year. And I'm not saying that's what we did last year. I just feel an emphasis in my spirit to make this an organic experience. And hey, if you're watching this and you were a part of Bible in a Year last year and you did not finish, no shame, no condemnation. I had to hustle. Like, I had to hustle to get done. But I finished. I finished by the year. I did videos for every single day, and they're up on the YouTube channel. So what I would encourage you to do, if you finished Bible in a Year with us, if you got in halfway or three quarters of the way, or you came in on the last tail of the journey, thank God that you made it. But hey, the journey isn't over yet. You know why? Because we're going to do the journey all over again. That's right. We're going to do the journey all over again. Every single day is available. So today we're on day two. Day two is available on the YouTube channel. And like I said, I'm going to be adding some content as I feel led to, as I feel necessary. But I'm not going to do a whole brand new Bible in a year, because for those of you that have not finished the series, it'll give you an opportunity to finish the series. You can read through the Bible. And if you've already watched the videos, you can watch the videos again. Maybe it'll stir up something differently. If you haven't watched the video is there to be a supplement. It's just supposed to be a supplement. That's not supposed to be your time with God. No, you got to spend your own time with God. And the video is just supposed to help stir the fire. I just want to get you thinking about the Bible, get you thinking about the Word of God. That's what that's designed for. A video of meditation, a video to help you reflect so that you can share your reflections in the comment section. I'm still going to participate in the comments. I'm still going to chop it up with everybody that's going through the series again. I'm going through the series again, the Bible in the year 2021. It's the same reading plan. It's just the year is changed on the end of the plan. Instead of Bible in the year 2020, it's Bible in the year 2021. But it's got the same scriptures. I've looked through it on my phone. I've compared the plans. It's the exact same readings. So I'm going to be reading through the Bible again. I'm not going to be doing brand new videos. I will, however, add updates as I feel led to, or as I feel just inspired to by the Spirit. But I'm not going to be doing brand new videos. I am, however, going to be focused on some of these concentration subjects that I've been wanting to get into for quite some time, and I haven't been able to because I haven't had time. We've been traveling the latter end of the year. Thank God for the little bit of a break that we got. It enabled me to catch up. And man, let me tell you, I've learned consistency. Thank God for that. So I'm going to keep doing that, but I'm going to focus my time on creating some other content that's going to help us be the church. For example, one of the things that we as the church are supposed to be doing is watching what we say. Yeah, the mouth is a big deal. And I've discovered, and this has been on my spirit, that so many people have a form of godliness, but have no power. Now, even myself, even churches that I'm affiliated with, I'm seeing this everywhere. Like, I don't think that anybody has arrived that I'm aware of. So I don't think that we should sit in a place of, oh, okay, I did it. I got it down. I figured it out. Boom, we've arrived. No, man, I feel like we got so much more to learn. I feel like we're so far from what the Bible is really teaching in a lot of different areas that we need to continue to tighten up. We need to be the church. We need to be the people of God. And I'm going to just comprise a study of what it means to be the church, what it means to do what the church is supposed to be doing. Because going to church on Sunday, hearing a preacher, hearing a message, I don't think that that's what was a part of the original apostles' outline, or that's how they did it. No, they spent a lot of time reaching the poor. I'm even thinking about this idea of witnessing. Like, we go around witnessing, and we're not witnessing anything. Telling people Acts 2:38 is the bare minimum of witnessing. That's like the cream on, that's like the icing on the cake. You know what I mean? That's like the cherry with the frosting. That's not real witnessing. We wonder why we walk around and we don't have any power. We're out here trying to lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. Yes, that's biblical. We're supposed to be doing that. We're out here trying to cast out devils and we're struggling with devils for like 2 hours trying to get people delivered. Yes, we're supposed to be doing that. But why is it taking so much? Why does it seem like we got to fight to get a little victory? When Jesus spoke, he said, come out, they came out. When Jesus laid hands on them, they were recovered. And this is my opinion. I think it's because the church has a form of godliness, but is denying the power of the Holy Ghost. And here is how we are doing that. Because we want to be so uber spiritual. We're so concerned about being apostolic and power and demonstration, but we neglect the weightier matters of the law. It's just like Jesus said. And that is the law of love. That's the law of when you see your brother hungry, you go and feed them. When you see people have a need, especially those of the brotherhood. When you see somebody got, okay, they lost their job due to COVID. They struggling. They behind on their bill. Now they're struggling with COVID. We want to go and lay hands on them and pray for them. God healed them, but they don't have a job and they're behind on their electric bill. We'll be so quick to lay hands on somebody and try to get them to be healed, and we won't lift a finger to help them come out of their financial jam. That's what we've been doing, and that's what we're still doing for most of us. And we call ourselves the church. Family, we got to reassess ourselves. We've allowed ourselves to be carried away, to be swept away with this modernized doctrine of what it means to be a Christian. We've lost sight of the kingdom. We're so worried about making the prayer meeting and going to church and making sure we don't miss service. We've neglected the real service. This is what James said. Pure religion and undefiled is this. I'm going to look it up because I can't quote that to you. Yeah, I don't know that verse by heart, and I don't want to just give it to you raw. But look, check this out. I'm going to give it to you. Pure religion. Because that's what we're trying to be. We're trying to be religious. But we're trying to be religious and we're trying to have power. I want to be able to go and cast out devils on command. I want to be able to go and lay hands on the sick and have them recover. But I wonder, maybe that's not happening the way that we are thinking or the way that we're expecting, because we got homeless people out in the streets. You know what? There's some of these other denominations out there. They don't have the Holy Ghost. They don't have the revelation of baptism in Jesus' name, but they're out here feeding the poor. I would dare to say that they're more apostolic than us, running around here speaking in tongues, baptized in Jesus' name. And we neglect the people. And you know what? Let me just go in. I feel something stirred up in me. We got people standing on the corner begging for money, and we justify, oh, well, we're not going to give them any money because they're going to use it for drugs, or we don't want them to go and get drinks or drink alcohol. When has it become our business to decide what they do with it? When Jesus prompts you to go give that person standing on the corner $20, and then you begin to reason yourself out of doing it because, well, I don't know why they're there. What kind of logic does that make? What kind of sense does that make? Since when do we not help people because of how they got into their mess? Now, let's really look at it. Are we being Christian? Are we being Christ-like? Because every single one of us got ourselves into the sin mess that we're in because we did it. Jesus ain't do it. Ain't nobody else do it. We did it. We screwed ourselves up. So, when we get grace from God, every single one of us has received a handout. And God never came to us and said, well, I'm not going to heal you because you're still doing drugs and because your life is still... Come on, man. What kind of garbage have we been doing, yo? Like, what kind of nonsense have we been involved in? We call ourselves the church and then we don't want to see... You know what? The Bible says, blessed are they that are poor in spirit, for there shall be the kingdom of God. That's what the scripture says. And we don't want to give the guy standing on the corner saying, I'm homeless, I need help, $20, because there's been some corrupt homeless people. Yeah? So what? So what? If you feel the Holy Ghost leading you to give the guy or the woman standing on the corner $20, don't reason yourself out of it by calling it wisdom and saying, oh, well, I have to be a good steward. No, you don't. The devil is a liar. You're selfish and you're not walking in love. I dare to say that. But that's not a pill that we as believers want to swallow. And let me tell you something. I'm guilty. I'm guilty of all of that. So I don't want it to sound like I'm coming off on people. I don't even know where this came. Yes, I do. It came from the Holy Ghost. Glory to God. But I'm guilty. I'm guilty. I'm confessing. I've done that. I've reasoned within myself. Now, God's been dealing with me about that and said, Klaus, it ain't none of your business. If I tell you to go and to do, it ain't none of your business how they got into the mess. It ain't none of your business if they get out of the mess. If I tell you go give them $20 and they go and buy a carton of beer, let me deal with them. But we want to play God. Why don't we be the church? Why don't we let Jesus worry about being Jesus? And why don't we do what he told us to do? That's love people. We've learned our way out of loving people. What we've come to do is we've embraced a system of religiosity that totally negates walking in the power of the Holy Ghost. I want the power of the Holy Ghost. What if we're not operating and tapped into that power because we've outthought ourselves? Thinking that, oh, well, you know what, we need to get them saved and get them delivered, and we're worried about what they're wearing. We're worried about, are they wearing makeup and jewelry, and are they walking around half naked? And everybody's not like that. I have met people, like genuine people. They care about souls, and they're out there. They don't care what you did. They're getting people off of drugs. That's what the church is supposed to be doing. What if every single one of us believers, those of us that believe, what if we went to our local city and we found all of the homeless shelters? We found all of the battered women's shelters, the places that people are going to that are struggling, people that are trying to get it together and they're having a hard time. What if we went there? What if we started pooling and helping these people get right? Oh, I don't have $35 to get my birth certificate. I need a ride to get my birth certificate. I can't get a job. I got people willing to hire me, but I don't have this money that I need, and I can't get the money because I can't get the job. I can't get the job because I don't have the documentation. I can't get the documentation because I don't have the money, and I'm stuck in this cycle. What if we stepped out and said, yo, I got you. I'll drive you up there. I'll pay for it. Send it to my mailing address. And get you started. What if we started doing that? We want to be used to do apostolic wonders, miracles, and we've neglected the weightier matters of the law. The weightier matters of the law. Loving the poor. What about this scripture here in James? James chapter 1, verse 26. If any man among you seem to be religious and bridleth not his tongue, you call yourself religious, you call yourself spiritual, but you don't watch your mouth? That's what the Bible is saying. I'm so glad that we get a reset, because I need all of this. I need to watch my mouth. I'm out here joking around. I'm saying empty words. I'm saying things that have no intention, no thought behind it. To what end? Am I speaking life or death? Have I bridled my tongue? Not according to James. My Lord, help me. But deceiveth his own heart. This man's religion is vain. So the Bible says, if I claim to be religious, if I claim to be a man of God, if I claim to be a believer in Jesus, but I don't watch what I say, or going further, watch how I say what I say. My religion is vain. The Bible says I deceive myself. I wonder if the reason why the deception will run so rampant in this age, last days that we're living in, is because Jesus said, take heed that no man deceive you. But it's easy to be deceived by other people when you've already deceived yourself. In instances like this, walking around claiming to be religious, claiming to be spiritual, claiming to be apostolic, claiming to have power, claiming to be baptized in the name of Jesus, claiming to have the Holy Ghost, the power of the living God inside of us, speaking in tongues and all of that. But we can't lift a finger to help our brother, or we speak idle words. Your religion is vain. Even if you have the Holy Ghost and you're speaking in tongues, but after you stop speaking in tongues, you start speaking foolishness and nonsense. Your religion is vain. Brothers and sisters, I would submit to us with this new year that we have. Let's be the church. I'm tired of having church. I don't want to have church. I want to be the church. I want to be the church. And I feel like Jesus is calling us to just be real, to be genuine, to continue on this path. Maybe not all of us have been sidetracked. Many of us have remained and stood the course. Glory to God. I need a reminder constantly, continuously. And God is dealing with my heart to be real, to be genuine. And here it is, James 1:27. Pure religion and undefiled before God and the Father is this, to visit the fatherless. Do you know how many fatherless kids we have? Granted, fatherless in today's society can mean absent father. Now, I understand that in those days there was a lot of war and men died and kids genuinely didn't have a dad. But today we have fatherless kids in the sense of the father has been removed by this corrupt system of society that we are in. What if we spent time dealing with the fatherless? We probably have less people going to prison, because these people going to prison today were the ones that were fatherless yesterday. What if we spent time ministering to them, reaching them, showing them that they have value? But we've neglected to do so because we did not show them that they have value. And we leave them open to deception. To visit the fatherless and widows in their affliction. To keep himself unspotted from the world. What on God's green planet does it mean to be unspotted from the world? I think, and this is my opinion, I think believers, and you're probably lukewarm, I think believers somehow have slipped into the mindset, how close to the world can I get and still be right? How unholy can I be and still be holy? How unrighteous or how close to the world can I get without getting caught on fire with strange fire? Brothers and sisters, we have managed to adopt a wrong mindset concerning this. What happened to the second mile principle? Going the extra mile. What happened to going out of the way, not to look like the world, not to act like the world, not to be like the world? True religion. This is what Jesus said. Somebody smacks you, turn the other cheek. We don't live that. Like really, literally, we don't live that. Somebody hits you, and out of humility and peace, you turn the other cheek. And I've struggled with this. I've told myself, you know what, man, if somebody smacked me, I'm gonna punch him and we go rumble. Hard, proud man. What did Jesus do? Every time they tried to kill him, he ain't strike nobody down. He ain't send lightning bolts nowhere. He tried to disappear. And then when it was time to go, he let them strike him. Now I'm just speaking examples. I'm wondering, what are we going to do? I know that this was supposed to be a Bible in the year video. Praise God. But look, this is how we can come back. Make a commitment. Be intentional. We need to be reminded. I needed to be reminded. This is the Holy Ghost reminding me. And I'm hearing myself speaking what I feel on my heart. And you can hear me. Let's learn to be the real church. Yes, I said, let's learn to be the real church, because I wonder, do we even know? And that's not to lay blame on you. You're probably doing the best that you can. You're doing what you've been taught. But let's go to the Bible. What is the Bible teaching us? Are we doing what the Bible teacheth us? Are we doing that? I want to live after the word of God. If we can't find it in the word, then why don't we try getting rid of it? And then do what the Bible says to do, to be the church, to be the children of God. What if every single one of us endeavored to learn how to be peacemakers? Remember, blessed are the peacemakers. Do we know what that means? Even in light of this political climate, are we peacemakers? Are we trying to uphold peace and unity? Or have we gotten carried away with the agenda and somehow found ourselves in left field, away from the path of kingdom? Because we got caught up in the things of this world. Now, Brother Klaus is not saying neglect politics. I believe as believers, we should be deeply involved. We should be. But what I am saying is we shouldn't be so deeply involved in earth politics that we forget that we are a part of kingdom. We're a part of the kingdom. We live in the United States, but we're a part of the kingdom. We are the church. So, do Bible in a year. Refresh yourself. Even if you read it already, go through the book again. You don't have to watch the videos. You can if you want to. You don't even have to follow that same reading plan. Start another plan, but get on a plan. Be intentional. Let's do that for 2021. Let's be the real church. Let's do what the real church is called to do. Research this with me. Don't wait for Brother Klaus to put out a video. Research this with me. Let's come together. Let's figure out how can we be the real church. Is witnessing really witnessing what we're doing? I feel like the Holy Ghost is going to lead us. I feel like the Holy Ghost is going to overhaul our carnal mind and help us to become more and more spiritual. Brothers and sisters, Happy New Year, and praise God for the grace that carried us out of last year. I perceive that we will need that much more grace for this year. But it's not impossible, seeing that you and I are here in this moment, sharing this moment right now. So all of the videos, as I mentioned earlier, for Bible in a Year, are on the YouTube channel, Digital Disciple Ministries. If you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, go and subscribe, hit that bell. If you've already subscribed, go double check. I don't know. I've heard YouTube has a way of unsubscribing people, unnotifying people. Listen, we're going against a corrupt world system. They don't want the truth out. The Bible gets banned in different countries and different places because they don't want people to know the truth. We need to be intentional about the truth. So, let's get into the truth. We're only on the second day. Start the plan. Get into the Bible. Be intentional, man. Don't be driving to work, listening to the video. No, but let's be intentional about setting time aside specifically to spend time with God. Brothers and sisters, I love every single one of you all, man. I want us to succeed as a church. I want to see what we can do in this new year. But more than that, I want to see what God can do through us as we yield ourselves vessels that will worship in spirit and in truth. May the Lord bless you and keep you, every single one of you. May He make His face to shine upon you. May He be gracious to you, and may He give you all peace. I'll see y'all in the comments. Bible in the Year 2021. Wah, wah. God bless you.
burns me.